from the source of a river to its mouth, the forces of moving water erode and shape the land. We call the action of flowing water on land fluvial processes. Fluvial processes can be broken down to the three main components of erosion, transportation, and deposition. For example, a river such as the Yangtze begins its 6,300-kilometer journey as meltwater from the glaciers on the Qinghai Tibet Plateau, where it erodes mountain sediment. As a river winds its way eastward across China, it erodes and changes the landscape, transporting more material. Eventually, the river reaches the sea, where the material is deposited in the Yangtze River Delta. Erosion. Moving water in the form of rivers are an agent of erosion. River water wears away rocks and soil found on the riverbed and banks. Rock particles being carried downstream continue to break down further as they are transported by the river. There are four main forms of fluvial erosion. Hydraulic action. The force of river water against the banks can cause air to be trapped and pressured in cracks in the rocks on the riverbank. This continual pressure causes the rocks to crack further and eventually break away. Abrasion. As the river transports rocks downstream, these rocks wear down the material on the riverbed. Attrition. Attrition is where the rocks and pebbles being carried by the river smash against each other, thereby breaking each other down into smaller, rounder, and smoother pebbles. Solution. Solution, or corrosion, is the chemical erosion of the rocks of the riverbank. This is because water is slightly acidic, especially where streams flow through rocks like limestone. Transportation. Once it has been eroded, material in the river is transported downstream. How this takes place depends on the interaction between the velocity of a river and the size of the particles. As a rule, the larger the particle size, the higher the velocity of moving water is required to transport it. When the river's course is steep, often near its source, velocities are higher, enabling the transportation of large rocks and boulders. During times of flood, energy levels will get even higher. Transportation takes place in four ways. Solution. This is where the smallest particles or minerals dissolved in the water. This usually happens in the middle and lower reaches of a river, as it takes some time for material to be dissolved. Suspension. Small particles are carried along in the river. This can take place anywhere along the course of the river. Saltation. Small pebbles bounce along the riverbed. This mainly takes place in the upper and middle sections of the river. Traction. This is where large boulders and rocks are rolled along the riverbed. This mainly occurs in the upper reaches of a river, as it is the only place where energy is high enough to do so. Deposition. When a river loses energy, it will deposit some of the load it is carrying. Energy levels are lowest when rivers meet the sea or lake and slows down, causing a lot of deposition to take place. Deposition features such as deltas can form in these places. Deposition also takes place when the volume of water decreases, as happens at the end of a flood or during a time of drought. Deposition also takes place further up the course of a river. For example, the slower moving water on the inside of a bend of a river will have less energy and therefore drop its load, helping to create a meander. A major depositional feature of a river is the floodplain in its lower reaches. This is made up of deposited sand and silt, which is known as alluvium. Floodplains are therefore very fertile and have supported large agricultural communities since ancient times. River profiles. The long profile is a slice through the river from the source to the mouth as seen in this diagram. Rivers are essentially trying to erode to their base level. That is usually sea level or sometimes a lake that the river may drain into. This is because without the force of gravity, water will not flow. Near the source of a river, which is often high in the mountains, a river will cut vertically to form a steep V-shaped valley. In these mountainous environments, a river will often flow over a series of rapids and waterfalls. As rivers reach their mid-course, they continue to cut downwards, but also cut laterally. Finally, as a river nears the sea, rivers flow over flat land, and most of the river's energy is concentrated on cutting laterally, thereby making the channel wider as it meanders its way towards the river's mouth. The cross profile of rivers also changes. Near the source, river channels are narrow and shallow due to the steepness of the terrain. Rivers in these environments contain many large boulders and rocks. With all this sediment on the riverbed, there is a lot of turbulence and friction which slows the water down. By the time the river has reached its lower course, the river is flowing fastest until it slows down on meeting the sea. Here, the channels are deep and wide, and the banks are the smoothest.